It was, let's start with Cartoonist first, and Dave sort of had the brilliant idea, what if you just do it on Cartoonist and comic strips specifically? Because we haven't seen that, and I'm a huge fan of comics and comic strips, and we both started talking and saying, you know, why hasn't there been a movie like this? We would love to see this movie. So let's see what we can do, and 4 years later, here we are with this movie. So hopefully you guys will like it.
And so what it is the basic idea of the film, for those of you not familiar with it, is it's a feature-length documentary on comic strips talking mainly about the past, present, and future of comic strips, but it's this particular moment of newsprint fading on the vine and digital taking off and what that means to the art form. And so over 3 years or so, we did about 77 interviews around North America. I think the farthest one we did was Lynn Johnston in the upper reaches of Canada, for better or for worse. And then we started with Greg Evans, who many of you guys know, down in San Marcos, who gave us 4 or 5 hours. Went to Jim Davis at Paws, and he gave us about 2 hours.
People like Scott McCloud were close to us.
A really pleasant thing happened about 2 years ago. We had written a very nice letter to Bill Watterson and gave it through channels that we knew would get to him. And we got an email back to him saying, yeah, I'd love to do the film. This is a passion near and dear to my heart. I love talking about comic strips. And at first, he just gave us written answers. And so after about a couple months of trying to incorporate it into the film in different ways, we emailed him and said, in the most respectful way, which of these three patterns would you like us to try to incorporate static text into, you know, the film? And he said, you know what, why don't we just record my voice, and we'll have my voice in the film. And the filmmaker's like,
That's a great idea, Bill.
We'll do it that way. So yes, we'll have your first recorded interview. So he was lovely about it. And this was his first time ever on being recorded. And you'll hear that tonight. We'll show that section for you.
And then we, when it came time to sort of release the movie, we were talking about who we'd love to do, you know, the poster and the art for it. And at the top of the list was, you know, Bill Watterson. But we thought, well, he'll never do this. He hasn't done a piece of cartoon art in, you know, 19 years. He did a painting, a beautiful painting. But he probably won't do this, but we'll just ask and he'll say no and we'll move on to somebody else. And he asked to see the movie, and we showed it to him, and apparently he liked it enough, and sort of said, you know, let me see if my
inkwell is not dried out.
I'll give it a shot. Yeah. And so he came up with this. This was his whole idea after seeing the movie.
Yeah, and we said, you know, the only way we'd ask you to do this is on two conditions. You have to like the movie, and you have to have an idea of the movie. We don't want this to be work for you. And you have to know that you have zero notes from us. We're not in any way going to tell you what to do or tell you what to draw or change anything you can do. And so he sent us this finished ink work and said, okay, here's a quick sketch. Give me some notes. And I emailed him back and I said, no, I am not giving Bill Watterson notes. No, you do whatever you want. He's like, no, it's your film. Give me notes.
And then I gave him a bunch of notes.
He did a beautiful water.
So we'll show you. I think we'll show you the first 5 minutes of the film, and then we'll skip ahead a little bit to the one of the sections. There's like two or three sections where Watterson talks in the film at length. So we'll show you that section too. We can probably sit down and do it from over here.
I read a review of it.
What's that?
I read a review of it.
You read a review?
I think so. And like the.